It is time for the monitor to come my way, and it is time to say hello to actor, author, and activist Antonio Sabato Jr. He joins us from Florida this morning. Sir, it's nice to see you. Good morning to you.
Good morning to you, and it's good afternoon here in Florida. How you doing, pal?
Very, very well. We've talked over the years. Let me ask you this, because it does generate headlines. It does generate controversy. You talk about in your book, speaking at the Republican convention in 2016, and after that appearance, there was a decisive market change in your career. What happened?
You know, God works in mysterious ways. You know, when you're against something really big in your life and you have to overcome it like I did after I came back, you know, and there's a lot of people in my business that just didn't like me after that. They were blacklisting me. People left me, managers, agents. I talk about it in the film, in the book, actually, and I talk about what happened to me. And I just, you know, to overcome something like that was something that it was not easy, but I did it with my family, with God, and everything worked out. I'm in a much better place now. I'm doing pretty good.
All right. Are you active in the election this time around?
I am, as an American, as a patriot, and I'm going to go out there and vote, and I'm going to support candidates that I know personally, and I'm going to support my party. I'm going to support our country and our flag and our police officers and so much more. But I support this flag right here behind me, and I support our president, who has done amazing things for our country, and we're going to have four more years coming up. Very exciting.
All right, I'll just ask you this. When you say we're going to have four more years coming up, there's a lot of pollsters and others who say, well, almost certainly that's not going to be the case. Of course, that was the thought before. Tell me about that.
There's going to be a landslide. You know, I was right the first time. I don't follow the polls. You know, the American people are going there to work right now. They're going out and working and supplying for their families and their children and whatever. So polls are really irrelevant at this point. They were irrelevant the first time, 4 years ago. You know, they had Hillary Clinton winning till the night of the election, and Trump was never going to win. And so for me, I see the enthusiasm on the street. You know, I work in construction. I work with great men and women who are building this country, who are building Florida with CNC concrete pumping. And I tell you, people are out there excited. They love the fact that this guy, our president, is overcoming everything. He's fighting for the American people and making this country a better place. And I know there's a dark side that is fighting against that, but at the end of the day, God is going to work things out, and he's already back at work. That's incredible to me.
Do you think you and or someone can have a successful Hollywood career and publicly harbor the views that you have?
Why not? Give me a reason why it shouldn't be. You know, that's the thing right there. I think we should be able to express our differences, but you know, to be a thespian, to be an actor, to work in this amazing business, we should take pride in that because it's an amazing career, an amazing business. But why is it politics affecting people's decisions, who to hire or not to hire, or my personal faith belief or whatever it may be? We should disagree and agree on some things, but at the end of the day, life is too important and our country is very important. So we should agree on that, at least that we want the best for the American people.
All right, you've moved to Florida. You've started a variety of other businesses. In your book, you say the book sort of serves as an advice guide for people who went through an experience that you've gone through as a young actor unfamiliar with Hollywood coming into Hollywood. Talk to me about that kind of advice.
Well, you know, since I've been working really hard, me and my production team, and, you know, starting our studio, Conflict Studios, and working on Trailblazers, which is a movie that I'm directing and I wrote with a bunch of great folks, you know, and we're working on that, and we're working on establishing a place where people can go, and if they're proud of this country, they can come work for us, you know. And I've been receiving emails from left and right, people in Hollywood, from casting directors, producers, executive producers. I mean, you're talking about drivers, carpenter, electricians, camera operators, who are just sick of this. They can't express what they love. If they love Jesus, they can't wear their cross. If they have a hat with an American flag, they're being treated like racist or whatever. They want to go to work. We just want to go to work, make movies, make TV shows, do what we love. And, you know, whatever is our personal beliefs, whether it's political or faith-based, that's our personal thing, and we should be left alone, you know. And so Hollywood is becoming really close-minded, and if you don't agree with certain things, they do bad things to you, and that's not fair.
All right. Hold up the copy of the book again. We'll tell folks that Antonio Sabato Jr., there it is, The Untold Story, is out and available now from Tampa this morning. Antonio joins us, and we appreciate that conversation. Back to Megan and Eric.